Hey everyone, Erin Bassett here. Today I'm going to be sharing with you about how I made this back to school board for the kids' pictures. I started off by creating this project in Scan and Cut Canvas, and then I imported it over to my Scan and Cut. Now before I got started cutting it out, I wanted to do a test cut because I'm going to be cutting this out on vinyl and I want it to cut through just the vinyl and not the backing. Now when you do a test cut, the cool thing is when you hit cut, it'll do the test cut and then ask you to evaluate how it cut out, so you know whether to continue cutting or not. You'll want to start off by adjusting your blade to the recommended settings and then trying that test cut. So you can see when I finally get that test triangle up that it did cut through just the vinyl and not through the backing. So I'm ready to hit start and continue cutting. So then next thing you want to do is weed out your vinyl. And I started off by just trimming off the excess because I don't want to get tangled up when I'm removing it. And when you begin to pull it, you just want to do it really gentle. You don't want to accidentally pull off any letters that you needed to keep, like this little A right here. So just take care when you're doing it. And don't forget to pop out the centers of the letters as well. This gridded transfer paper is my favorite way to transfer vinyl designs onto my projects. And you just want to make sure you burnish it on there really well. And then when you lift it off, it'll just peel off your letters. And you can take it over to your project, line everything up, and then go ahead and burnish it again. And then when you're finished, just peel up the transfer paper and you're finished. So besides the grid making this transfer sheet awesome, it's also reusable. So you can just stick it back on that backing and use it again. For this next section, I went ahead and used some magnetic sheets of paper, and these are printable ones that I went ahead and printed off my design on, and now I'm ready to scan and cut them out. Now, when you hit that scan button, you have a couple options here. That direct cut will scan and cut what's directly on your mat right around the outside of the letters. If you want the inside of those letters, you need to do scan to cut data. You'll need to change the recognition mode to match whatever you're scanning in. So if we're doing black and white, stick with black and white. And then just hit start. Now after it's finished processing, we're going to choose that second option, which will cut around the outside and the inside of letters, and then we're going to crop it down to the size we need. Now our next step is to save it, and there's a couple different ways to do it. We can save it to the machine, to Scan and Cut Canvas, to USB, or to our computer. And I'm just going to save it to my machine right now. And it tells us okay. And now we're ready to hit that home button because we're ready to cut this out. So we're gonna go into patterns and save data from the machine and find it. It's the last one we did. And you can just click okay. And we're gonna add a test cut back in since now we're cutting out the magnet sheet. And I'm just gonna put it at the bottom so I can easily tell if it cut through or not. And again, I wanna change my blade before testing it out. And if everything cut out well, you're ready to hit start. And now we're ready to just pull those all off and put it on our magnet board. And now, whenever we need to, we can switch out the grade year, we can switch out the first day to the last day, and go ahead and take our pictures. For more information on Scan and Cut, visit scanandcut.com. And for more ideas and inspiration, visit erinbassett.com.